Prophecy confirmation.
The government will no longer mandate the wearing of face masks anywhere.
And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. As they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and ye shall be established. Believe his prophets, so shall ye prosper.
It was all part of the plan of the Lord that even in the United Kingdom, this people will be defeated.
The government will no longer mandate the wearing of face masks anywhere.
Prophecy is the mind of God revealed unto humanity by the interpretation of his prophets. In the book of Amos, number 3, verse number 7, the Bible says, For the Lord God does nothing unless he reveals it unto his servants, the prophets.
Spoken to me, and the Lord of heavens has revealed to me even the mysteries of his kingdom. In the vision of the Lord, as the Lord begins to speak to me about the nations of the earth and what the Lord is doing all over the world, the Lord has begun to say to me that I'm opening up the courts of heaven, and as I'm opening up these courts, changes will begin to take place all over the world. There's about to be a time that is embarrassing to many of those who are in positions of power. The Lord is about to humiliate those who thought they have control over this world. The Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and said to me, Son, the armies of heavens are open, and the courts of heavens are about to begin. As we begin this month of November till to 2022, the God of heavens has spoken to me that the courts of heaven about to be open, and I see a new realm of angels being dispensed to the planet Earth. Family, God is about to send different types of angels to the Earth that we have not seen before. There shall be tears in government amongst many. The United Kingdom, that even the confusion of Boris Johnson will begin to be clear and clear that it was all part of the plan. It was all part of the plan of the Lord that even the United Kingdom, these people will be defeated. Why will they think they will even own streets of London. The Lord says, London, Rome, especially Washington, shall be the chief centers of revival. I will waken up my people, and they will begin to rise against them. I will establish my altar as the courts of heavens are opened.
So, this morning, the Cabinet concluded that because of the extraordinary booster campaign, together with the way the public have responded to the Plan B measures, we can return to Plan A in England and allow Plan B regulations to expire. Yeah. As a result, from the start of Thursday next week, mandatory certification will end. Yeah. Organisations can, of course, choose to use the NHS COVID pass voluntarily, but we will end the compulsory use of COVID status certification in England. Yeah. From now on, the government is no longer asking people to work from home. Yeah. And people should now speak to their employers about arrangements for returning to the office. And having looked at the data carefully, the Cabinet concluded that once regulations lapse, the government will no longer mandate the wearing of face masks anywhere. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Speaker, from tomorrow, we will no longer require face masks in classrooms, and the Department for Education will shortly remove national guidance on their use in communal areas. In the country at large, we will continue to suggest the use of face coverings in enclosed or crowded spaces, particularly when you come into contact with people you don't normally meet, but we will trust the judgment of the British people and no longer criminalise anyone who chooses not to wear one.
It was all part of the plan of the Lord that even in the United Kingdom, this people will be defeated. That God has sent me on an assignment, and God has sent me for a specific prophetic visitation that I may go to pray and intercede from Robben Island in South Africa. Thank you for watching Jesus Reigns TV. I believe that you are blessed by the testimonies, the prophecies, the teachings that you keep receiving into this channel. Family, I believe that God is doing great things all over the world, and your life is also being transformed, and Jesus is reigning over your life. The prophecies keep coming to pass each and every hour. Testimonies are coming, and many people's lives are being transformed by the messages that are being taken out of this channel. I believe that God is only just beginning, and the best is yet to come. I want to encourage you never to forget to become a partner with Jesus Reigns TV by making sure that you become part of the partner's role using the details that are on the screen right now. You can send the email and request to become a partner of Jesus Reigns TV, and you will receive an email which will give you the partnership form. I believe that God wants us to be partners into taking the gospel all over the world. I say each and every one of us is a product of somebody else's partnership, of somebody's offering for us to receive the gospel. So you can also save another soul by partnering with the gospel, so that the gospel can go all over the world. Now, I want to give you this opportunity. As you have heard me preaching the word of God, you say, man of God, I've heard you prophesying, I've heard you teaching the word of God, and I see the testimonies as well and what God is doing. But the problem is that me, myself, I don't know Jesus. I don't have a relationship with Jesus, and I've never met Jesus Christ. So I want to lead you into this prayer of salvation. And I believe that the Bible says we believe in our hearts, confess with our mouths, and we are saved. And as you make this prayer, God is going to change your life, and God is going to transform you. So just make this prayer after me. So Lord Jesus, today I believe that you are the Son of God,
You rose and you died and rose again. And I believe that in your word, I am saved. I believe that you are the King over my life and the Lord of my life. In Jesus' name. As you made this prayer, I believe that Jesus has entered your heart. Simple. The Bible says, believing in our hearts, confessing with our mouth that Jesus is the Lord and we are saved. So right now you are saved, and I want you to continue living according to the word of God. The Bible says the word of God is a sure word of prophecy. So as you receive the word of God, your life is going to be changed. So thank you for watching. My name is Yamkela Joseph. I believe the next time I see you, it will be in your own city, in your own town. God bless you. I love you so much. Shalom. Shalom.